Jenny, I know that we talk an awful lot in this Find Your Purpose Now podcast about people who are really unhappy, suffering, having a hard time, struggling. And I don't know if we pay enough attention to the people who are actually doing it, who are living their purpose and having the time of their life. So I thought we should talk about that today.
Well, I agree. I think it's really interesting to be in a position to encourage people to find their purpose. But you and I have met a lot of people who are in their purpose. And so it's really fun to kind of share today some of our insights about people who are living their purpose, which I think is amazing.
It absolutely is. So I have to tell you, okay, so I got this review out of the clear blue, and it kind of made me think, oh my gosh, why don't we just talk to these people who are doing it instead of continuing to try to persuade them to do it? There are people out there doing it. So here's what this lady wrote to me. I read your book. I was adopted and I had a lifetime of struggles and successes. But now, 8 months after reading your book, I'm going back to college to get my bachelor's degree in computer science. I'm saving and I'm investing money and I'm happier than I've ever been. Your book was sensational. God bless you. And the book that she's talking about is Succeed Because of What You've Been Through. I don't specifically say, I don't think, I wrote it, 12 years ago. So I don't really remember saying anything about specifically, you know, finding your purpose. But when we decide that we're going to do the work of sorting through what we've been through, you know, I always say mining the lessons out of what we've been through, but when we decide, okay, you know what, I can't change what happened to me, I can't make that husband come back, or I can't make, you know, this person who passed be alive, I can't go back in time, I can't change anything, but I have today. And I have however many days I have left, and I'm going to not be a victim anymore. I'm going to see myself as the survivor I am. And people decide to do that. And it's that mindset change, Jenny, that you've talked so much about as a certified life coach, I think, that sort of opens people's eyes to the possibilities around them.
Well, and I think about this. I mean, I'm just trying to draw an analogy. You know, it's a mindset, but it's often the lens that we're looking through. So, I mean, you wear glasses, I wear glasses or contacts. And when you go to the optometrist and they sit and twist the different A or B, one or two, or depending on how the doctor says it, and it becomes clearer and clearer. And so when that lens is off, when that lens is not right, when you're looking through it to get your right glasses, it doesn't work. And you get to a certain prescription and you know that's the one, because then it becomes blurry and fuzzy. So I would use that analogy with people and encourage them when it comes to looking at their purpose, looking toward their purpose, living their purpose, to make sure that you're looking through a clear lens. And sometimes we need to wipe it off. Sometimes we need to change the prescription in how we're looking toward our purpose. And once we do that, it becomes clearer and clearer. And sometimes for some people, it's just deciding that I'm going to make this change, or I'm going to go for it, or I'm going to take a risk, or I'm going to. And that might be that slight shift, that slight change in the lens in which you are looking at your purpose.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, what a great analogy that is, because I know how that feels to sit in front of the machine and, you know, and it's all blurry. And then when they finally, like, literally dial in the right combination and you can see crystal clear. Mm-hmm. I love that, because you and I both know that for a lot of people, they want to fulfill their purpose. I mean, they're not averse to finding and fulfilling their purpose, but they don't know what it is. And deciding I'm going to find it is the first step. Maybe not the first. Maybe you've talked before. You say all the time, it's discoverable. So maybe the first thing is just believing that there is a purpose and then deciding that you're going to find it. And then, you know, to kind of unpack your analogy, I think about, okay, so when I was in my early 20s, I might have heard you and said, that's great. Where do I go to that optometrist? you know, who dials it all in and boom, my purpose is there. Mm-hmm. And I can see my purpose. So I think the way that I think of it, I'm curious to know what you think about it. The way I think of that, you know, dialing in of like figuring out how do you get clarity on it is, for me, praying and asking God, what do you want me to do? What are we doing today? And then I specifically say, what good can I do today? Who can I help today? And then I don't hear an audible voice. I wish I did. It would be so much easier if I would just hear, Rhonda, I want you to do, you know, okay, I'm good. I'm a good rule follower. Give me the bullet points. Give me the rules, the parameters. I'm good. Doesn't work that way. But what I try to do is I try to pay attention to my thoughts, pay attention to what happens, pay attention to opportunities. So here's an example of what that looks like. You know, we had our speaker bureau, successful survivor speaker bureau, and COVID killed it. And so I really wasn't even thinking about speaker bureau and all of that. It's just, you know, it's a tremendous amount of work and so on. But after this prayer, okay, what are we going to do today? Who can I help? What can I do? On this one particular day, I got a call from somebody who said, we need a speaker at this event. And it was going to be hundreds and hundreds of kids, young kids, and then another event in the evening for parents and grandparents and really the community at large. And I can't remember exactly what this person said about the kind of speaker they wanted, but as he was describing it, I got somebody in mind. I'll just tell you who it was. It's Tyrus from Fox, professional wrestler, Fox News contributor. He's on the Gutfeld show. And this person who was looking for a speaker, in my mind, like every single thing he was saying, he was describing Tyrus. And I said, gosh, I think I might know exactly who would be good for this event. Now, I don't have a speaker bureau. I don't have any there's no marketing material, nothing exists. Well, I mean, the old stuff exists, but I wasn't prepared to just leap in and, oh, well, let me just book a speaker. But I felt the Holy Spirit leading me to help people in a way that I could do it. And I did it. And fast forward, the events went spectacularly. So the speaker, Tyrus, I think was exactly what those kids needed to hear. He's, for anybody who doesn't know, he's been a teacher. He's been a child care worker in a private nonprofit child welfare organization that exists to take care of abused kids. He was mistreated as a kid. He's been through really hard times. So when he's there speaking to these kids, the most amazing thing, Jenny, and you as an educator, you know, imagine 800 kids completely silent, leaning forward in their chairs, literally hanging on every word. And the messages that Tyrus shared with the kids, I 100% believe were exactly what those kids needed to hear in that moment. He talked about what to do if you're being bullied, what to do if you're being abused, how to handle the curveballs of life. I think he called his talk Wrestling Through Childhood Trauma because he's a professional wrestler. And I say all that to say that I didn't go there and do that, but I was just able to make that connection. That connection was part of my purpose. Mm-hmm. So what did I really do? I took a phone call. I heard about somebody's dilemma. I thought, oh, okay. Well, so I reached out to this one. It just wasn't that hard. So I got clarity, back to the analogy of the optometrist. I got clarity in that moment about what I was supposed to do that day. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I tend to think about purpose as something that, okay, I'm going to start this today. I'm going to do this for the next 35 years. Or, you know, the person who sent me a message and said, I've gone back to school. I'm going to get my bachelor's degree in computer science. Great. We're talking about something that's not going to get done today, right? Getting the degree. Now you got to get a job in the field or using that expertise that you've just gained. Okay. So it's a longer term thing. So I just wanted to make the point that, you know, sometimes it's just as simple as what we can do in that moment.
Right.
The good that we can do that day. And maybe it goes someplace and maybe it doesn't. But in the meantime, I was able to solve somebody's dilemma. They needed a speaker. And hopefully a lot of people benefited.
Right. And you don't even have to be there to see it. It's just knowing that God will do it. You know, so I think it's so beautiful to think about that. Our purpose is experienced in all the moments. It's not just necessarily one particular thing or one particular place. You know, if you work for one company, you could work for another one and still fulfill your purpose. It doesn't have to be the same one. You know, so I think it's so neat that our purpose can be found in all kinds of moments. And I mean, it's like when you get a gift basket and there's all kinds of fun things in it, every single thing is fun. So if we look at our purpose like a big basket of gifts, there might be smaller things and bigger things and things that last longer than other things. You know, the chocolate's going to be gone that night, but the cocktail might last for 4 months, you know? I mean, really, it's crazy how, and I think a lot of times when the road gets tough, we somehow believe that our purpose is snuffed out. And because God's given it, it's not going to be taken away. And all the curveballs and all the hardships and the bumps in the road don't negate our purpose. And that's cause for celebration.
I'm so glad you said that, Jenny, because I can't tell you the number of people, you've probably heard this too, who say, I'm too old. I'm, you know, maybe 20 years ago, but not now. What could I do now? Oh my. Well, let me just tell you what you could do now. You approach every single situation with a wisdom that you didn't have 20 years ago. A perspective, context, expertise, ability, maturity. I could go on and on. When I think, because I used to think that way. I used to think, well, boy, I wish I had the energy I had when I was in my 20s. I could work 100 hours a week. I got so much done. I was just rocking and rolling and large and in charge. I can't do that anymore, Jenny. But I think, okay, what if I had to work all those hours because I didn't know the shortcut, because I didn't know how to do something. So I had to sit for hours and try to figure it out, where maybe today I can sit down and, oh, I don't know, like an example would be, I would work for 3 hours and agonize over writing a business letter to communicate maybe a complicated concept or whatever. And I wanted to say it in such a way that I didn't create liability, and I wanted to make sure it was clear, and I'd read it and I'd reread it. I'd put it down and walk away. I'd come back to it. You know, I could probably wake up now at 3 o'clock in the morning, be out of my head asleep, and sit down and whip out that letter. Mm-hmm. So, you know, too old? No, that just doesn't fly. It doesn't hold water. I didn't get the right education, or I didn't come from the right family. I don't have a support system. I don't have anybody to help me. I don't have enough money. Name all the things, right? And we could go on. There are a million things. Oh, I'm not pretty enough. I'm not smart enough. I don't know the right people. I don't know anybody. As a matter of fact, I mean, you could just go on. You could make you could come up with a million different reasons why you think you can't fulfill your purpose at whatever place you are right in this moment. And I don't want to dismiss the fact that there are people caring for elderly parents. There are people caring for children who were born with birth defects. And you know, these are permanent, or at least nothing's really permanent. This whole life is temporary, but there are long-term things that people have to deal with. And yes, it takes time. And if you're in a season in your life where you have to deal with that, then that's part of your purpose right now, is dealing with whatever you have to deal with grace and patience and peace and a lot of prayer. Right. But those things aside, everything else, well, I shouldn't say everything. A lot of it is noise, excuses. And I know because I've made a bunch of them. I have every excuse in the world why I don't want to go to the gym, Jenny. And you know, because you've heard them all. So I know all about making excuses. I also know that I will do what I really want to do. Mm-hmm. We all will make time and somehow figure out how to do the things that we really want to do. Mm-hmm. So what I'm hoping that everybody listening today is going to get from this is, you know, shift your mind and decide what you really want. Do you want to live your purpose? Are you willing to maybe take a little risk? Because sometimes it involves a risk, right? I mean, I can pray. I can get a clear leading from God. Okay, I'm supposed to do this. Okay, going back to my example of contacting Tyrus, first of all, I didn't even know if I was going to get through to Tyrus. Second of all, I mean, it's not like we're, you know, best buddies or something. So, and then who knows? I might have reached out and he might have said, you know, and completely blown me off. I could have been afraid. I could have just not even mentioned that I think I know who would be a perfect speaker for you. I could have not mentioned it out of fear or out of, gosh, I have 400 other things that I need to do that I've already obligated myself to do. I really, you know, don't have time to be helping this other person. But I felt like I followed God's leading. Right. I just went ahead and did it, even though it was uncomfortable, even though reaching out to Tyrus was awkward, even though I risked perceived failure. And then I would have had to gone back to this person and said, I'm sorry, I can't get, you know, and that would have felt embarrassing. Maybe what we have to do is say, you know what? I'm going to take today and I'm going to pray and I'm going to take a chance and I'm going to do what I think God leads me to do, even if it's awkward. Even if I might wind up embarrassed. I mean, what's the worst thing that's going to happen, right? You try to do something and it doesn't work out. And you say, gosh, sorry, I tried. It didn't work out. And then go with it. But what if it does work out? Right?
Right. I mean, you know, I think at the end of our life, Rhonda, we don't want to go through our life and go, I could have, I should have. And then we have all this regret because we never were willing to try it. You know, it's like a little kid who gets on a bike, and most little kids know they're going to fall off that bike, but most kids learn to ride the bike because they want to have the experience of riding a bike. And when they fall off and even get hurt, they get back on, you know? And so I think we can even take a small lesson from children, you know, when it doesn't work the first time, I get back up and do it again, because those things get formulated into patterns of excuses. And we just want everybody to be able to experience their purpose and have a blast doing it, even if it fails.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, you know, the idea of, you know, back to, no, we don't, I mean, I hope if you're listening to this and you do hear an audible voice from God, let me know. Cause I would love to like dial my radio into that, my receiver into that station and, you know, hear the God download. But you know, until then, I think it makes sense. Pray and then pay attention. In the conversations that you have, receiving an email, getting an invitation to go somewhere and do something that you wouldn't normally do. This is the eye doctor, A or B. When you go and do something, pay attention to how you feel. Pay attention to how the people around you make you feel. Do they make you feel welcome? Do you feel comfortable? Do you feel like you belong there or not? And just pay attention to those feelings. Now, some of those feelings might be, gosh, this is awkward because I haven't done this before. Press through that. Yeah. But trying things and doing things that maybe you haven't done before, this is how you find out if you like it. And you might, like maybe tasting chocolate for the first time, you might do something and go, whoa, this is where I'm supposed to be. This is what I'm supposed to be doing. And that's a door opening.
Yeah.
That's the door to your purpose opening. And like the example that I gave, I think I'm one of our podcasts. I don't know. This is the 102nd one, I think. So in one of them, I said, I never thought I would be speaking in public. Not something I ever thought about or wanted to do. And, it made me nervous, but I did it for a friend. But I realized, Jenny, in the doing, not before, not 10 minutes before, certainly not 10 days before, my stomach was doing this, you know. But when I got up there and the mic was hot and the lights were on me, I was supposed to be there. Mm-hmm. It clicked. It just clicked. And in those times when you do say yes to an invitation or a thing that somebody asks you to do or whatever it is, and you get that feeling like, okay, I'm supposed to be here. In your prayer time and in your quiet time that you have on your own, really break that down and say, what about that did I really like? What about that made me feel good? What character traits did that pull out of me? What abilities did that tease out of me that I didn't even know I had? And just really think about that, because the abilities, the character traits, the personality traits, all these things that you and I have talked about, when we get in that place where we go, whoa, I'm loving this right now. I don't ever want it to end. I feel more alive than I felt in a long time. Whatever those things are that you're using, you're supposed to be using those things. Mm-hmm. And by recognizing, okay, wait a minute, I'm thinking about me on stage, last thing on earth that I would have ever wanted to do. But when I started thinking, okay, ability to communicate, ability to really connect with people. And as I was going through, I thought, that's what I'm supposed to be doing. It's not sitting at my desk running a business, pushing paper, doing HR kinds of things, you know, where if I had to discipline somebody, I guarantee you that I was far more upset than anybody that I ever had to, you know, discipline, because it just killed me. I hated it. I hated those kinds of things. And yet that's what you have to do when you're a business owner. There's aspects of it that you don't like. And so as I looked at all those things that I utilized for the first time, I thought, I want to do more of that. And there was none of that mm-hmm. in the work that I was in. Mm-hmm. And that's how I knew, oh, okay. I thought that was my purpose forever. But that's how I knew that that season was over. And it was time to pivot and do something new.
Mm-hmm. Because the reality is when you uncover that, when you uncover, you discover. And so that's what we're encouraging people to do, is just change that mindset, change that lens, wipe it off. Once you uncover it, that's when you discover it. That's really, truly what I believe. And that saying of your purpose is discoverable, it is. And you.
Well, all right, Jenny, I can't wait to talk to you again next time and go down this road a little bit further about purpose fulfillment. I know that there are a number of people I've spoken to who are living their purpose, and they're willing to share how they found it and just how it came about. And hopefully that'll be helpful to everybody who's listening now. So come back and join us. If you have any comments or if you would like to join us on the podcast, the link is below. And I want to encourage you to go to our website. We're going to be adding some free downloadable tools that'll help you find your purpose. So we look forward to seeing you again next week.